The ship, Tron, is huge. It looks like part of the dock. The ocean beyond is endless.
Are we going to go across this ocean? Why?
In orderly fashion, we marched up three gangways with our kit bags.
The smell of the sea. Salt. And Freakus leaping up with High Crown! Hai Lang!
There were 13 officers and 4,200 labourers strong, 8.5 companies altogether, with 5 interpreters and a medical assistant.
11 PM to 1 AM. 2 hours during which the wind steadily increased in violence. A typhoon shrieking. Sleet lashing the deck.
The next day, the ship was coated in ice.
My ears. The wind had dropped. My ears were pierced! A sharp shrill whistle! I didn't even feel the ship move.
All of us. We. Rushed to the deck rails and scuppers.
When will they return?
The gale had left a considerable swell in the North China Sea.
Terrified some of the Chinese, who began bowing up and down.
I let them impress.
I tried to cheer them up by laughing at them.
Childish! Coolies. Aged 14 to 18.
There are thousands of us in the hold.
I couldn't stand straight. The ship rose and fell. Rose and fell. My stomach knotted. My head did not stop spinning.
I wasn't affected, but it was upsetting for me to see my Xiongdi brothers suffer so. I tried to help as best as I could.
The Chinese showed a sort of spirit that made one positively love them.
Quite wonderfully good in adversity.
When we felt better, we explored the engine room, the forecastle head, the gun platforms, the galleys, steel plates, lifeboats, life belts, winches, twisting all nuts and everything mechanical, everything.
The coolies brought their lax habits along. Orange peel, paper, peanut shells, leek stalks and other malodorous things discarded everywhere.
Well, we divided them into sanitary squads and we divided them into police, police, stokers, cooks, cabin and bar boys, bakers or laundrymen.
The cabin boys wore white smocks. They called themselves angels.
They loved to make beds and dance smocks, and if we had a photo of a loved one, they would make paper flowers to decorate the frames with.
We were very organized in the ship. We had gangers overseeing us. Haircutting and shaving was carried out by our brother barbers. Those who were bakers learned to bake bread from the Lao Wai chef for breakfast.
They were always happy to volunteer.
They were a coughing, spitting people. A disregard of their person. A savage aversion to washing.
Some of us learned how to work the electric motor.
Just think, one reason not to wash clothes with hand.
They have responded to stern treatment with the right. Spirit of obedience.
We fought for the garbage tins!
One company tried to outdo the other in cleanliness.
They were simple, submissive, and remarkable at enduring serious illness.
Wonderfully healthy. Magnificent bodies.
They were fine with the bare necessities of life, and remarkable in extreme labor.
Constant nagging, endless explanation, and strict punishment has awakened in them the pride of a clean life.
It was good to learn British ways. One night, the engines fell silent. The full moon hung in the sky.
Are we in France? England. The sun rose. We saw little boats full of people in kimonos.
We're in Nagasaki, Japan.
They've placed ladders on the side of the ship. They are loading coal.
It wasn't long before the engines fired up again. The Chinese, eager for new experiences, crowded onto the forecastle and stared at a disappearing Japan.
The secret of maintaining peace and satisfaction among some 4,000 coolies on a long trans-Pacific voyage was to endow for them each day with interest.
We wanted to gamble, but that was strictly forbidden.
We did play chess, though.
Money still changed hands from time to time.
We sprung a surprise on them, a sale of musical instruments.
We were so delighted to learn from those who could play.
Some
could
play the fiddle. Others could play the flute. Dizu.
We felt our homes dancing in our hearts! Ha! Ha!
气爽，身体棒棒的，到来年男女老少全都棒。